first began as a city about 700 BC right here on Tiber Island. Surrounding itself with water, Rome grew as trade expanded and water supplied life to the entire area. Ruins of this first Roman hub can still be seen today in the island's boat-shaped fortifications and the statue Asclepius, god of healing, that first brought inhabitants to the island.
Today, water can still be seen flowing throughout Rome. It's in the scattered Nasones, flowing through fountains, and rushing through the Tiber River after a spring storm. There is no question that water plays a huge role in Roman life. However, there is one area where water seems to be missing, at the dinner table.
Through this documentary, we hope to better understand the role that water plays in the lives of the average Italian, both culturally and gastronomically. There is no lack of water visibility in Roman geography or architecture, but it is noticeably lacking from the table. In many countries, tap water is provided free of charge to all restaurant guests. However, many in restaurants in Rome only provide bottled mineral water at the same cost as a soft drink. Today we are talking to Andrea, owner and chef of Le Fate restaurant in Trastevere, to get his take on water's role as a beverage.
Today we're here to explore the role that water plays in the Roman eating experience. In your experience, do you serve tap water at your restaurant free of charge? Why or why not?
Yes, we offer water free of charge at the restaurants because of if customers are requiring something from the tap, of course, we don't charge any money. At the same time, if some of those customers are requiring for a bottle of water, in this case, we'll be charging money. And otherwise, there is another option that most of the restaurants, of course, all of them, because it's pretty expensive, but most of the restaurants has, we have a little machine, which is microfiltrata, which is basically microfilter water, or basically it's a little bit like more easy to digest type of water.
Now, do you find that very many Italians order water? What about Americans or other tourists?
Everybody order water. I mean, Italians, Americans, any other tourist, it depends on the nationalities. I can tell you that definitely Italians are more used to have sparkling water than tap water. Tap water is something that we can have at home. You open the sink and you drink it as much as you want. So what's the point of going to the restaurant and ordering tap water? For us, it's more like something a little different flavor. We order sparkling water. Then, of course, on top of our meal, there is always wine, which is something extra. Water is not really an extra.
Do you consider water an important drink to Roman culture?
Definitely. We have in Rome, there is a saying which is called Acqua del Sindaco, which means the water from the major of Rome. So in case of the water from the major of Rome, we always liked it because it's for free. It's never been charged.
Le Fate is not the only restaurant that thinks it's important to serve water free of charge. Bacchanale of Trastevere also provides this service.
Do you serve tap water here free of charge?
Sì, serviamo acqua del rubinetto.
Do you find that a lot of people ask to get the free tap water when they come?
Sì, ogni tanto, quando mangiano chiedono acqua del rubinetto.
And why do you think some restaurants refuse to serve free tap water? Is it expensive to the restaurants?
No, non penso sia costoso per il ristorante. Penso soltanto perché vogliono far pagare l'acqua in bottiglia, basta, tutto qua.
Hey, can we get two tap waters and another beer, por favor?
Yeah, of course, it's free.
Grazie. The beer?
No, the water.
Recent discussion of privatizing Italy's water has created outrage in much of the population. The law to privatize public services, including water, is currently in front of Parliament. Politicians in favor of the bill argue it is necessary as part of a European Union law on a free market competition, while opponents say water is a basic human right that should not be subject to the free market. On June 12th, the public will be able to vote on a referendum regarding the privatization of water. We'll now go to Kelsey on the streets, where she'll ask some people's opinions on the water issue.
What is your opinion of the government push to privatize water?
Non sono d'accordo perché l'acqua è un bene pubblico.
Ma penso che questa decisione del governo sia totalmente negativa, il fatto di privatizzare, perché l'acqua è un bene comune, è un bene di tutti, per cui tutti devono avere pari possibilità e non avere dei prezzi accessibili.
Is the water privatized in England?
It's not only privatized in England, it's privatized in Wales, Scotland and Ireland as well. Yes, it's privatized. It was privatized in the 80s, in the era of Margaret Thatcher. And at that time, the government's philosophy was that It had to ensure a service was provided, but not necessarily be the provider of that service. And therefore, the government sold off all of the water facilities to a number of private enterprises, a number of private companies.
What is your opinion of the government push to privatize water?
Dio, bisogna vedere come verrà gestita tutto qui, dipende da chi e come si gestisce l'acqua.
Devo dire che io sono abbastanza d'accordo, a differenza di mio marito, sono piuttosto d'accordo sul fatto che l'acqua debba restare pubblica. Anche se, appunto, è vero quello che diceva lui, che anche gestita pubblicamente spesso fa nascere delle speculazioni, però preferisco che sia gestita dal pubblico.
Water privatization has created conflicts in other parts of the world as well. In the case of Bolivia, the conflicts even turned violent. Hopefully, Italian government listens to their constituents in regards to this vital resource and human need.
By looking at Rome's water history at Tiber Island, talking to Andrea of Le Fate restaurant, and getting some citizens' opinions on water privatization, we have a better understanding of water culture in Rome.
So, when in Rome, do as the Romans do.
Began as a city about 700 BC right here on Tiber Island. Surrounding itself with water, Rome grew as trade expanded and supply...
I'm here with our two producers, Corinne and Melissa.
Oh, hey!
You mean the best producers? Serious work on this project here.
My eyes
hurt. The project going so far?
I think it's going excellent. We got some great opinions, and now we're rewarding ourselves with some soups.
Yeah,
that's not actually soup, but it's soup lead.
Awesome now.
Don't go chasing waterfalls.